Hello and welcome to this first video on the hardest GCSE problems of all time. In this series, we're going to be exploring a bunch of different difficult GCSE questions. If you are outside the UK, GCSEs are examinations that students in England and Wales take when they're about 16 years old. And these are ones that have been particularly badly answered according to examination reports. So a very small proportion of students have got it right. And this one, this particular problem, I've seen a few YouTubers try to tackle. One, in fact, got it wrong, but don't worry, we're going to get it right. So let's read the question and then we'll tackle it. And if you do enjoy this video, please do like and subscribe. We'll be greatly appreciative. So the diagram shows three circles, each of radius 4 centimetres. The centres of the circles are A, B and C, such that ABC is a straight line and AB equals BC equals 4 centimetres. Work out the total area of the two shaded regions. Give your answer in terms of pi. What I think makes this a particularly difficult problem is it's hard to know where to start. This is a particularly complex region we're finding the area of, and you might not have found an area like that before. Now, when it comes to complicated regions like that, that you're trying to find the area of, I like to think of it like this. How would you make it out of paper? So you could take different bits of paper and stick them together so you add the areas, or you start with a shape and then you cut out of it so you subtract areas. Now this looks more like a cutty-outy problem because, look, if we start with this circle in the middle and find its area, and we know how to find the area of a circle, it's just pi r squared, then we can subtract this region on the left and this region on the right, and that will leave this region at the top and the bottom. So that's what we're going to do. But then the question is, well, how do we find the area of this leafy region on the right, for example? What kind of shape is that? And again, we need to think about how we can compose it into shapes that we know how to find the area of. We know the formulae for the area of those particular shapes. Now, there's various ways of breaking this up, but the way I'm going to do it is to split it in half. So I'm going to add a line like this. And then the area here, so just half of this leafy region on the right, that is known as a segment, and that is a shape that you do cover in GCSE about how to find the area of, and let's explore the formula for that. So if I do that on the right here, so add a line here. Now, if we start with a slice of a circle, like a pizza slice, if you like, it's known as a sector, and then we cut out the triangle on the left, we're left with this region on the right, which is known as a segment. So let's just label that. That is known as a segment. So how do you find the area of the segment? Well, you start with the area of the pizza slice, and then you cut out that triangle on the left. So the area of the pizza slice, well, you start with the area of a circle, where this is radius r. We start with the area of a full circle, and then we've got to find the appropriate fraction of the full circle. So what fraction is it? Well, if we make this angle here theta, what fraction of the full circle have we got? Well, we've got theta 3/60ths of the circle. So we're going to do theta 3/60ths of the area of the full circle, pi r squared. And then, as I said, we're going to subtract the area of that triangle on the left, and we can use a formula which I'll explore in another video, half AB sine C. That's the area of a non-right angle triangle. So what you do is you do half times the length of one of the sides of that triangle, well, R, times the length of another side of that triangle. Well, this would also be R at the bottom because it's also the radius of that sector. So we times by another R, R times R is R squared. And then we times by the sine of the angle between those two sides. We call that the included angle. So the theta is the angle between those two R's. So we do sine of theta. So that is the area of a segment. Now we can use this now to find the area of that shaded region at the top. So, well, the yellow region. So the area of that yellow segment, so this particular region here, is, well, is theta over 360. Well, I haven't identified what that theta is yet, so let's work that out. So if I add some more lines into this, if I add a radius to that middle circle, and then another radius here, can you see that this shape here is just a sector, it's a pizza slice, and then because we've cut out that triangle, we're left with that segment. So we need the radius and the theta of that particular segment. So We've got the radius here we know is 4, that's the radius of that particular circle in the middle, and we need this angle here. So the way we could do that is, let's, if we add a line on the left here, we know that's 4, we add another line, that's also 4. And in fact, if we added another line again, the radius of the middle circle, that's also 4. We can see that's an equilateral triangle on the left, so this angle here is 60 degrees. That's the interior angle of the equilateral triangle. And if we add another triangle at the bottom, that's also 60 degrees. So we can see by symmetry that angle there is going to be 120 degrees. So now we've got everything we need. The area of that segment is, let's use the formula on the right, this formula here, theta over 360, so 120 over 360, times by 4 squared, pi times 4 squared, sorry, and then we're minusing half r squared times sine of 120. Now, this is actually, believe it or not, a non-calculator paper. Now, how would we find sine of 120 degrees? Well, it's actually the same as sine of 60 degrees, and I'll explain. Now, in other videos, we explore how we find sine, cos, and tan of like common angles, like 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees. And sine of 60 degrees, I'll just tell you it's root 3 over 2. But then how can we use that to find sine of 120? So if I draw a trigonometric graph, so if I draw a graph of sine of x, so let's just go up to 180. And the graph looks like this, and it goes on further, but we don't need the rest of the graph. So as I said, we know that the sine of 60 is root 3 over 2. But sine of 120, which is here, that looks like it might be the same. It might also be root 3 over 2. And the reason we know that's right is because this graph is symmetrical, about 90. And we can see that 60 is 30 below 90 and 120 is 30 above 90. So therefore, by symmetry, sine of 60 is the same as sine of 120. So sine of 120 degrees is root 3 over 2. So let's use that. So we've got a third times pi times 16. Minus half times 4 squared is 8. Sine of 120, we said, was root 3 over 2. Let's just simplify that now. Third times 16 is 16 over 3. And then 8 over 2 is 4. So we've got 4 root 3. So we've got the area of the segment, and we're nearly there. We've nearly found this area of the shaded region, the top and the bottom. So as we said earlier, we want to start with the area of the circle, which is just going to be pi times the radius squared, pi times 4 squared. And then we're going to subtract both these leaves on the right and the left. Well, we've worked out the area of just this yellow segment. How can we find the area of the whole leafy region? Well, we've got one of these segments, two of these segments, three of these segments, and four of these segments. So we've got four lots of segments that is what we want to cut out from the circle, right? So let's do that. So the area of the shaded region is, so we start with the area of the circle, pi times 4 squared, and we're going to subtract, as we said, four segments. So it's 4 of that area we found above, so 16 over 3 pi minus 4 root 3. Now, the question just says, find the total area in terms of pi. We've done that. In fact, I think you would probably get full marks this answer because it doesn't say simplify. But just for the sake of completion, I am going to do that, get a nice tidy answer. So let's just simplify. Pi times 4 squared is 16 pi. Let's try and expand these brackets. So we've got minus 4 times by 16 over 3 pi. Remember, when you times a fraction by a non-fraction, it only affects the numerator of the fraction. So when we do 4 times 16 over 3, you do the 4 times the 16, which, so it's 64 over 3. So we've got minus 64 over 3 pi. And now we're going to do minus 4 times minus 4 root 3. Minus 4 times minus 4 is 16, so it's plus 16 root 3. And finally, we can tidy up even more. We've got some like terms here. We've got two pi terms there. One's fractional, one's not. Let's turn the non-fractional one to fractional. Since the second one is 64 over 3, I'm going to put the 16 as something over 3 as well to make the fractions easier to subtract. So 16 is 48 over 3. And now they're both over 3, which is good. And then we've got to do 48 thirds minus 64 thirds. That's minus 16 thirds. And I want to put that positive term first. So the 16 root 3 I'm going to put first. And then we said the pi terms came to minus 16 thirds pi. And that is the final answer. That is the area of the shaded region. We are done. Now, I hope you enjoyed that video, and I look forward to making more in this series on the hardest GCSE problems of all time. Thank you for watching.